Alright, welcome back to StarCraft SMP Season 2, where today we're going to take a look at a completely new area here on the server. The player shops. So we've actually had player shops before in StarCraft in Season 1. Now the player shops were absolutely not popular back then, so eventually when we actually wanted to start Season 2 we decided to remove them. We had like 8 player shops there, nobody bought them, and the people that did nothing with it. Some didn't restock and others just didn't build a shop at all on the plot. They just did nothing with it. They bought it and that was it. But eventually the server was getting more and more popular and more people actually started to join. And eventually people just started creating their own shops. So at their homes they were just going to start creating shops. They were making marketplaces and they were making small shops, and they would just have chests in there with items they wanted to sell, and then they would have like the price on the sign or something like, okay, if you want to take this from the chest and leave 10 diamonds. Well, of course, nobody did that. So a lot of people actually just got scammed because they were putting something for sale, somebody took it, just didn't leave the correct number of diamonds behind, and yeah, the shops were kinda a mess. And eventually I got so many reports of people actually wanting the shop plots back that I was like, maybe we can actually reintroduce them. And we did. So brand new here on StarCraft are the player shops. You are now able to create your own player shop here at spawn or wherever you want. You can literally create your shop everywhere in the world. But there are also some plots available here at spawn that you can buy and actually create a shop on. So when people first join the server, they will immediately see your shop, which is like the best advertising you can get. Anyways, before we start, it would really mean a ton if you could leave a like on this video and also check if you are subscribed to the channel. My analytics show me that most people are actually not subscribed, which really hurts my feeling. Why not just press the subscribe button and click on the notification bell? It would really help me out. You can always unsubscribe in the future if you change your mind. And yeah, it just takes a second. Why wouldn't you? And then, without any further ado, let's dive right into it. So the player shops are back on StarCraft SMP Season 2. Now there are actually two ways now to create a player shop. You can either buy a premium plot here at spawn and actually create your shop on there, or you can just make a shop wherever you want in the world. Now there are a few differences, so let me explain. These signs explain it as well, but I'm just gonna explain myself. So we have a plugin on the server called Chest Shop, which actually allows you to turn a chest into a shop. So let's say you have this chest and I put a lot of stone in there. And after that I place a sign on here with this format, Casasura 10. 10 is then the amount of items I want to sell, so in this case 10 stone. Then you have a B or an S. A B is for players buying your stuff and an S is for players selling stuff to you. So in this case I want to sell stone to somebody, so that's why the B is there. B5, so that means I want to sell it for 5, and then stone. So 10 stone for 5 diamonds, because diamonds is the currency here on the server. It's the worst deal in the world, but it doesn't matter, it's a clear example. So this shop sells 10 stone for 5, like you can see, 10 stone for 5. You can make a chest shop everywhere in the world. So at your own house, if you want to create a shop there, you can create a chest shop there, and it will be a completely safe way to sell your stuff. There's no way you will get scammed, because nobody except for the player that actually created the shop can open the chest behind it, and the server will actually decide if you have the right amount of money to actually buy what's inside of the chest. So it's a scam-free method to create your own shop. And you can do this everywhere in the world, but you can also decide to buy a premium plot at spawn. So a premium plot at spawn actually looks like this. There are also some bigger ones and there are also some smaller ones, but this is what a plot looks like. And you can just basically create your own shop on there. It will cost you some money though. The smallest plot is, I think, $100. But the plus sides of having a shop, a premium shop at spawn, is of course, first of all, it's a nice central place. So people can just do /spawn and they will immediately be in a shopping area. And they can just go around all the shops, see if they can find whatever they need. It's a very easy place to come back to, so it's also a very good place to build your shop. Also, the whole area is always protected. So this whole area, nobody can edit anything here except for Diamond MP. Diamond MP bought the shop, he can edit everything in a plot he wants, nobody else can. He's the only one that can place chests here, he's the only one that actually can create shops here. It is just his plot. So that are the main reasons people would want a premium plot, at least I think so. And yeah, many people actually wanted a premium plot, because almost every single plot here has been sold out. I think we have like 14 premium plots, and yeah, Almost every single one of them has been bought. By the way, one thing I'm forgetting, one thing I need to explain is how to get currency, how to get diamonds, how to put your diamonds into money. So the currency of the server is diamonds, which means that you can transfer diamonds into money by clicking on this sign. So the currency used is diamonds, transfer it into money here. So if you have diamonds with you and you click on this sign, you will actually sell the diamonds for $1. So one diamond is $1. Now if you have 100 diamonds with you, you will have $100 on your bank account. You can actually do /money to see how much money you have on the server. And if you have $100, you can, for example, buy this plot. After that, you can create your own shop here, so you can make like your own shopping area. You can place chest shops there. You can actually start selling stuff, and hopefully eventually you will make back your money. And to buy stuff from other shops, you will also need currency. You will also need dollars. So then you can go back here, you can sell more diamonds, make more dollars, and with those dollars you can actually buy stuff at our shops. Now let's say you've sold tons of items and you have so much money on your account and you actually want to set it back to diamonds. You can also do that. So you can buy diamonds again, one diamond for $1. You can literally transfer all your money back into diamonds here, and then you can just use the diamonds for, I don't know, diamond stuff, whatever you want. So that is how the player shops here in StarCraft work. Now I just want to go around this shopping area for a bit and see what everybody has built, because I haven't actually taken a close look at everything and I'm kind of curious what everybody is selling. So shop one is from Diamond MP. Okay, so Diamond MP is selling a name tag. Oh, three name tags for one. Okay, interesting. Also, one saddle for 2, one beacon for 32, 128 puppies for 1 diamond. Okay, I don't know why I would want puppies, but sure. That's actually a good deal because I don't have bamboo. Blaze rods is also a good deal. Nether wards, I have tons of that. Terracotta, I could actually use this. Ooh, there we go. I think it's actually a pretty good deal. Like, of course you can make a blaze rod farm, but now I don't have to make the farm myself. Here, an invisibility potion, which is also nice. Okay, I really like your shop. I also really like the design. Like, that's a thing, of course. If you make your shop a spawn, you need to make sure it actually looks a little bit great. I mean, it is spawn. You are literally allowed to create a shop here at spawn, so make sure it looks a little bit great. So here we have a shop that's actually still for sale. Now, somebody had this shop before. I think they just sold it and bought another one. So that's a little bit sad. It's an empty plot, but hopefully somebody will buy it again and build something great here. Let's go to shop number 3. There we go. From CoolKit 2009. Gunpowder, nether wart. We got a limited item. Yeah, I see. I'm not able to buy anything. Thanks for the limited item. Totem of Undying for 25. One for 25. I literally have one of those totems in my inventory and I don't know what to do with it. Yeah, I know what to do with it, but I'm not really a PvP guy or whatever, so I'm not gonna do anything with it. But 25, that's a freaking lot. Okay, whose shop was it again? CoolKit. CoolKit 2009. Nice shop. Sell more. Okay, next one. We got shop number... That's 6. Where's 4? Where's 4? Is this 4? This is 4. And why cat shop? Oh, you are not selling much. Wood storage. Okay, those are all storage chests. Here we got cobblestone. Lots of cobblestone for 1. Pretty good deal, I think. Is that a good deal? I don't know. Okay, let's go to, I think, probably the best looking shop in whole spawn. It's from Rocking Penguin 89, the new helper here on the server. We actually got 2 new helpers. Rocking Penguin 89 and Dust Mob are the 2 new helpers here on StarCraft. They are actually the new staff members here on the server, so they just need to make sure that the peace and balance and kindness on the server remains, I guess. But here we got Rocking Penguin's 89's Stop and Shop. Ooh, it looks so nice. I really, really love the design. I really do. Let's see what you are selling. You're selling bones, emeralds, spruce log, oak log. I could actually use it. Out of stock! No! Oh, I need that. I need that. Rocking Penguin, if you are watching this video, please, mate, please restock the spruce. I need lots of spruce. Bread. We got carrot, potato. Bread, I could actually use that. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, we got some bread. Nice, nice, nice. So, here we got Brittle Shop. Now selling sand. Well, that's good. Okay. Brittle, iron ingot, and sand. You're also selling cobblestone. For 1 diamond, you get 490 blocks. That's a pretty good deal. Because I saw 300 something somewhere over here. I didn't know where it was. Was it over here? Somewhere I saw a... Yeah, here. 384 cobblestone for one diamond. And here you got 490. So of course you got a more superior deal here. That's clear. Normal stone, sugar. Normal sugar. No sugar cane. Okay, sugar. Baked. Oh, I bought the baked potato. Oh well, I food is always welcome. Is there something upstairs? There isn't yet. Okay. Wait, I thought you were selling sand. Or did I just miss that? Where's the sand? Oh, there's sand. That seems like a bad deal. 46 cents for one diamond. Okay. Next shop is from that guy. I didn't even know how to pronounce that. The Toko. Foods and other popular items. Ooh. Dark oak log. Golden carrots. Gunpowder. Baked potato. And that's about it. The shops are only here on the server for a little bit, so I think most people still need to actually make something of it. Oh, there's no sign. Oh yeah, this is genius. Oh, I really love this. So somebody, Raging Redo, he actually created a shop just outside of spawn. So this is spawn. This is outside of spawn. You can see the message. You've left spawn. I guess. You're allowed to do that. That's fine. There's nothing I can't keep you from doing it. But yeah, okay. I don't even know what to say. Next one. What do we have? We got his shop. Doesn't look like he's selling anything yet. But I think he just bought this shop today, so I think they will still come. Also, somebody enchanted my sword. Look at this. Mending, sharpness 5, and breaking 3. I'm really happy with that. The only problem is that I don't really remember who did it. But somebody was like, can I have your sword for a second? And I was like, it doesn't have any enchantments. Sure, here you go. And then he enchanted my sword. And yeah, now I got a good sword. I don't know who did it. But thank you very much. Thank you. I really needed that. Looks like a flower shop. But nobody is really selling anything here. Oh, there's so many mobs. There's so many mobs. No. Oh, okay. So we also got these mini shops. So the mini shops are actually shops that are one chest or two chests. Well, actually, they're all one chest, but you got like a single chest and you got the double chest. And yeah, it are just mini shops. They are literally one chest shops. If you just want to sell one item, you don't want to build a whole shop, or you want to actually buy a whole plot, you can just buy one mini shop. I'm selling some ender pearls over here. Very, very bad deal, but it doesn't matter. The admin is selling some poppies here. Agent Oxalot selling the Heart of the Sea here. People are actually using it. Not that many though. I think most people just don't get it. They think it's a bad deal. You spend 6 diamonds on the server once, and after that you have this nice chest here at spawn that you can use for your own shop. It's I don't know. I think it's nice. If you don't like it, you don't have to do it. But I think it's a pretty nice deal. Now, this is also one of the better looking shops here in the server. I have to be honest. Ancient Oxalot shop. So we actually made a shop plot inside of a mountain. And Ancient Oxalot actually fully used the shop to its potential. It's actually created a mountain shop. So you actually go inside of the mountain and you will see the shop here. It looks so great. I absolutely love it. So we got an enchanted book here. I don't know what the book is. Like, I see enchanted book, but I don't know what enchanted book #4 means. No idea what it is. Enchanted book #5. Also nice, we got a totem of undying for 20. Oh, that's a pretty good deal. Like, I've seen many people sell a totem of undying for 25. Asians is actually selling it for 20, so that's a good deal. That's a very bad deal. Because, like, in the first shop, I think I bought 32 for one. It says Totem of Undying, but there's actually gunpowder there. So I'm very, very confused. Okay, then the last shop is up here from Dustmob, the other helper here on the server. Dustmob shop. And this puppy was bought from YezuCree2 for $10 or 10 cents. Thanks. Nice puppy. We got Punch 2. Oh, these are enchanted books. That's nice. It actually says the names. That's what we need. So Fire Aspect Sharpness 5. For one diamond? That's a good deal. I need stuff. I need this. Efficiency 5. What? I get efficiency 5. That's so cool. Okay, unbreaking. Does he also have unbreaking 3? Unbreaking. Ah, out of stock. Oh, that sucks. Okay. Doesn't matter, I have efficiency, that's pretty good. What can I put on my axe? I actually need efficiency one more time then. Ooh! Okay, another efficiency 5. Feather falling, I could use that. Oh yeah, we got feather falling. Ooh, somewhere I want Frostwalker. Like, I only have mending and stuff on here. I would also really like to have more unbreaking. Unbreaking 3. It's sad that it's all out of stock. Does he also have an anvil here? He does! Okay, so fortune. Let's put it on there. Let's also put efficiency. It costs 20, what? Okay, never mind, I will wait. Need to go to a mob farm then, but that's really good. I love this shop, this mob. I really do. It's a great shop, it's a great shop. And if you see this video, please restock the Unbreaking 3. I need that. It's our shop over here then. Hello, kitties. Hello. Dust, snowy, Snickers, Smokey, Boots, Cats Without a Name. Alright, now these are all the premium player shops we have here at Spawn. Of course you can create a shop wherever you want. You can just go to your house, create a shop there and make sure that people can come there for some reason. That's all possible. We will try to make more premium plots in the future, but eventually Spawn is just full and we won't make any more premium shops after that. Or we need to make some kind of shopping district. That could also be a very, very fun idea. I would actually love to have that on the server, but that would just take some time. But yeah, amazing new shopping area. There are still one plot available. So if you see this video and you also play on StarCraft and you didn't know about the player shops yet, hop on the server, buy a plot as fast as you can because this is your chance. There might be more in the future, but I have to be honest, eventually, like, there's just a limit. The spawn isn't that big. So eventually it will just stop and you won't be able to buy a premium plot anymore. We won't make new ones endlessly. So buy it, do it. Alright, so before we end this video, I want to show you my house. Because, of course, I've showed you the new house. I have moved recently from the old house to the new one. In the last video, you saw how I basically built this whole house. So first of all, we now got the bedroom over here. It was supposed to be the enchanting room before, but I actually moved it because I just needed a little bit more room. And something happened actually. So the enchantment room is now over here. Look at that. It's like the perfect corner for an enchantment room. It fits perfectly. I actually wanted to make it so that you could go here through the hallway and then here to the right. And then you could just go here, there would be a hallway here, and that would go to like the forest. That was a bit the idea was in my head. But then very quickly I realized that that's completely impossible. Because if you go straight here, you will actually bump into the chest room. Because the chest room, of course, these chests here, they stick out quite a bit from the room itself. So it was actually impossible to make a hallway here. So then I decided to make the enchantment room here, because let's be honest, this is the perfect place to have an enchantment room. In the room where I first planned the enchantment room, I now actually made a bedroom. So we got a bedroom here. Finally, for the first time in StarCraft SMP, I have a freaking bed to sleep in. How great is that? Oh, wait. Ooh, I don't have a place for the anvil now. So yeah, here we got the brewing hallway. So I actually thought of making a brewing hallway. I said in the last video, I just wanted to have like a hallway with some brewing desks and stands. And then I could just, you know, do brewing here. And that's exactly what I made. So I made 2 desks here. One over there, a small one, and one big one over here. We got brewing stands on it. We got a flower pot with a cactus in it because it just looks nice. Underneath the desks, we got water. So you actually have enough water to do your brewing. And over here, we got an empty barrel. But eventually, there need to be glass bottles in here. So when I want to brew, I can just grab a glass bottle from here, go to the brewing stand and start brewing stuff. Now over here, we got a very small but very efficient nether wart farm. Okay, it's probably not the most efficient farm in the world, but it actually grows quite fast. I already have, how much nether wart? It's in this chest. Yeah, there it is. Okay, 28. I got 28 and everything you see right here. So let's just farm it. There we go. And we got 44 now. Look, very efficient. I've actually changed my mind. I'm just gonna put this inside of the barrel. There we go. There's the anvil. Now, originally, I wanted to make the farms over here. So I wanted to make a hallway and then I wanted to put the farms there. Of course, that didn't work out because I bumped into the chest room. So now I started making the farms over here. So there is a new hallway you can go through. So the first farm we got here is the wheat farm. It is still quite small, doesn't matter, because the only thing I'm gonna use it for is myself and maybe a cow farm in the future. So it doesn't have to be that massive, but you know, this is fine. This is enough. Let's actually grab the ones that are fully grown. so we can expand it a little bit. And there we go. Easy. The farm has been expanded. Now, if we go further into the hallway, we will come into the second and last farm for now, which is the potato farm. So on most SMP servers, I just eat potatoes because they are really, really easy to farm. They are also quite easy to obtain and they also seem to grow fast. I don't know if they actually grow faster than any other crop, but it doesn't matter. It feels like they grow fast. So, yeah, we just got the potato farm here. Unlimited food. Unlimited food. And that's actually it for now. These are the new areas of my home. It's not that much yet. I actually didn't have that much time to expand my home, but I've gotten a little further. And I think over the next few days, if I have time, I'm gonna make some more farms here. Maybe I will also start making some mob farms because I really need and want them. But I have to say though, overall, I'm really, really happy with how the house is turning out so far. Like, I think it is looking really, really fine. It really has a cozy feeling and I do really enjoy that. And then before I end this video, there's one more thing I will have to say. Please read the rules of the server. Please do. Recently, another player got banned, and to be honest, I really do not enjoy banning people. I really hate it. Because the people are playing on the server, they're just having a good time, and then I have to be the guy like, no, you're not allowed on the server anymore. That's just no fun. I do really hate banning people, but some people just deserve it because they're not following the rules. And even though I don't like banning people, we are following the rules. Because StarCraft has rules. Wanted to say it one more time. Because like active StarCraft players might already know, if you break the rules, you will get banned. And then, that's all for now. Guys, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like. And if you are new to the channel, not subscribed yet, and you are enjoying the content, make sure to smash that subscribe button and click on the notification bell. You would really, really, really help me out by doing that. You actually would. And then, that's all for now. And I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.